We all see the saga taking place with Tom Brady. We can debate if your personal life is in bounds as a professional athlete or not. If the rumor true is Giselle wrong for not supporting him and his decision to keep playing.
Let me start this off from the perspective of a man who's been divorced.
What?
At some point, you got to put your wife and your family first. Tom Brady's in his 20th year in the NFL. Who the fuck plays 20 years?
Shit, Tom Brady, the GOAT?
Is it for money? Because he's the number two career earner in his family. She got bread. She got money. So he's not playing for the money. He's playing
legacy.
Because he's selfish.
Legacy.
I feel like they had the perfect making of what it was supposed to be like. The problem is, and stay with me here, back in the day, what we used to tell our women was stay home, be a housemaker. That was the role of a woman. I don't believe in that. I believe whatever it is that you desire, you be. So if God called you to be a homemaker, whether male or female, then do that open-heartedly and with fucking so much love. But the reality is, we all are, we're individuals. So for me, I was a ball player. Now I'm a businessman. Now, your lady, whatever it is that she wanna do, support her in that. So the reason why I said they had the perfect makeup, because if you don't have an identity outside of the marriage or outside the relationship, then somebody is gonna be pulled down.
Nah.
Great. Hold on 1 second. Let me finish. Track with me. Football player. Oh, you on the pedestal. You king. I ain't got shit going on at home. That's a problem.
No, it ain't.
Hold on. Track with me. You're not listening to what I'm saying, Pat. What I'm saying is it's okay to have a lady at home that's a homemaker if they're okay with that, if that's truly what God created them to be. But there's some women out there that's supposed to be fucking judges. There's some women out there that's supposed to run their own businesses. There's some women out there that's supposed to be entrepreneurs.
But hold on.
But
if you weren't doing this shit before I met you.
Hold on, let me finish, bro. Let me finish.
All that shit you talking about, bro, that's bullshit. Because all that, I made it to the league. What? Excuse my French ladies, you know, I'm married. So I ain't trying to disrespect the woman. Hey, little bitch, stay home, take care of the kids. All this, tell me what you going, baby, what you want to do? You want to go shopping? Go shopping. Go ahead, do all of that. But I don't have no problem with what you want to do. But, like, you can't say that if you wasn't doing it before you met me. Now, if you was a doctor, a lawyer, whatever you was before we met, I can respect that. But don't tell me now that
she was a supermodel.
How was Tom Brady selfish, Omar? How was he selfish? I disagree on
trying to get to that.
How was he selfish?
She was a supermodel. She was worth more money than him. She worth $400 million.
She knew what
keep
she was signing
you,
up for.
Keep did doing she, what you're doing, Tom Brady.
But so she took a back seat.
All right, let me get quick
because
I could be long-winded. Here's the thing I'm saying, O. Here's what I'm saying. You talked about, he playing 20 years. Well, if I worked in finance, or if I work as an attorney, they work 50 years. So why are we separating the athletes? Like, you can only play ball for 10 years, 15 years. He's redefining what an athlete is and the longevity of an athlete. So why we got to put a time stamp on an athlete? If he played 30 years, they should be okay with that.
Because she want him home.
The attorney ain't home.
Do y'all what do y'all think?
Yeah, we need to
hear. Y'all tell us what y'all.
We need to hear y'all.
Okay, so my name is Mia.
Hey, Mia.
Hi, guys. All right, so to Brandon's point, you said that basically why would you put a time stamp on an athlete? I don't think it's necessarily about the career, but when you get married, I think it's about the discussion between you and your partner and what you and your partner decide. So in this case, of course, we don't know them personally,
right.
But I feel like he's had his time. He's had his time. Uh-oh. And now.
Ho.
Let her finish.
All right, go ahead. I ain't going to interrupt.
Go ahead, finish. Go ahead.
Don't interrupt.
I'm sorry.
He's had his time. And like many people are saying, what more is he looking for? Like, what, it's not the money. Is it just a manhood thing? Is it his identity is wrapped in football, so he doesn't want to let it go?
He's already the GOAT, right?
I got a question for it. I got a question for you when you're done. Go ahead.
So my thing is, if your wife comes to you, and this is your wife, and we
she
all
right
know she was that woman before.
She still
so,
is.
Huh?
That's my wife right there. She's that woman.
Okay, so if your wife comes to you, and you've had your time in the spotlight, and you've done what you set out to do, and you just want to do that extra, but your wife says, babe, let's travel. Babe, let's do this. Let's do us. Let's leave. That's, you did that.
Baby,
you were
I'm
great
not,
at it.
That last point, done. I know, DJ, you got a question.
I'm real quick. Yeah. You can get to your question. The NFL offseason for Tom Brady start after the Super Bowl.
Right.
So from February to April, babe, we can travel wherever we want.
You're going to put a time
outside
stamp
of that,
on your
I got to work.
But that's basically putting a time stamp on your relationship.
Yeah, that's right. That's
but
right.
Why?
That's right.
Why would you put a time stamp on your relationship?
Because every other
but
job.
But not on your career?
Listen to me.
Ooh, she got him right there, didn't she?
I'm listening.
Because every other career, you don't get no 2-3 months off.
Yes, you do.
No, you don't.
He just get time
get
off.
B, let me get her.
He just get ahead. The summer off.
Three months.
Hey, hold on, B.
2 months.
Okay, that's the only. That's the only profession. Good
excuse
job.
Me,
you
man.
Got
me can
on
I
that
ask
one.
You one question?
You got me on that one. The teacher.
Right, get mine off. Let me get mine.
But the teacher can't go to Italy because he's only making 45, or she only making.
Oh, flag on the play. Flag on the play.
Bang, 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 bang.
Flag on the play. Flag on the play, Brandon. I don't like that. I don't like that.
Hey,
I'm a teacher.
Hey,
Brandon. I'm a teacher. I'm a teacher.
Hey, hold on.
Hold on, time out. Hold on, hold on. Y'all, listen, respectfully, y'all should be making $100,000 because y'all touching our babies and y'all pouring our babies every day. But that's what it is.
I got a question, though.
And we learned how important
hold on, you guys were
during the pandemic as well.
Jack got a question.
Having to raise our own kids and teach our own kids.
Jack got a question.
Learn how important y'all were.
Let me hit her. Have you ever fell in love with something you love to do and it's a passion? For something that you grow up as a little kid. Say it's not a teacher, whatever that was, you grew up as a little kid and you fell in love with it. And you put so much hard work into it, and then one day you woke up and it's a professional. Like, damn, this shit got serious. Mm-hmm. Have you had that experience? So to turn your back on that, at a snap of a finger to say, oh, I'm gonna leave that, I'm gonna walk away from that, and just, I ain't gonna never miss that game that I fell in love with as a kid? That's something hard. So I do understand a part of, we married and this a partnership, we working together. Yeah, I told you 10 years ago I'm done playing football. But guess what? I walked away from it, I can't do it. Something about that locker room, something about that brotherhood, something about that camaraderie is different.
Yeah.
It's like we all grew up a certain way. Whatever you love growing up, you might be in the hood making money, whatever. You making money. So you just supposed to turn your back from making money, like, oh, I gotta go check. That's hard. A lot of motherfuckers fall that trap, so it's hard.
No, I definitely agree, but I guess the term turn your back is like, you're not turning your back. You've done it.
No, he's
to who?
It's not
who,
though.
No.
I want it more. The billionaires, you think the billionaires get money and they stop making money? I don't want money no more.
But look, the thing is, we don't know the personal conversations that they
facts.
Have. So we're just speculating from the outside. So when you say to turn your back,
right.
This could have been something they discussed 5 years ago. And she gave him the time frame and said, okay, we're nearing near.
That's where they went wrong, though. Because I agree with you. That's exactly what happened from what I'm reading and what I'm hearing is that he said I was going to retire at this age, at this point, and he didn't. But that's where they went wrong. And that's why I said, and we can go to the next topic, but I said they had the perfect template. When you walk into relationship, I'm accepting you for who you are and your dreams and what makes you who you are. And you need to do the same. Don't put no fucking timestamp on that. I'm Tom Brady. I'm the GOAT. Bro. I'm going to fucking play until my fucking shoulder fall off.
100%.
Thank you.
That's my thing. Who determines when I'm done? Who, like, isn't that your decision? Or can somebody, like, not like that, but can wifey make that decision for you?
As someone who has set in Giselle's shoes, mm-hmm. it does begin, in my opinion, with a conversation. My husband and I had a conversation. And I was the businesswoman and an entrepreneur as well when we first met. I was getting to my bag.
Period.
Yeah.
He pulled up on me and I pulled up on him.
Yeah.
I'm your shit.
Like you supposed to.
So listen, we had a conversation and we understood where each other were. And I understood where he was in his career. And so we both made decisions. And I made a decision to understand the business and learn the business and decide that this is what I was signing up for. Mm. And that was our conversation. So what I did with my career was, I said, I'm going to learn how to, for us to be business partners and run this thing like we need to. I incorporated what I did into his career and found a place where it both can benefit.
True boss.
True.
And also, I also said, and I'm going to do that part-time because my full-time job is what I chose to do was to take care of home. Until he finished and raised the babies and work on the other businesses that we had.
Come on. Shit.
It started with a conversation and understanding. Now, when it came to a time that he said he was done, my first question was, are you sure? Because you do have to understand the business. And as the guys were saying, it's not easy to walk away from something that you've done
since
20, 30 years of your life.
Sure.
Every day from 5 a.m. to 6 p.m. or 8 p.m.
Amen.
So it's a part. It becomes a part of your life. So you have to have deep discussions, and you got to decide what you're gonna ride out and do. Now, if he stopped and decided to go back, I knew what I signed up for. So I'd be like, okay, dust them off and get on back out there, but make sure your body is still whole enough for the kids when you're done.